Good morning, friends. Today we are going to have a session on IP address. So first of all, we'll go in the thing that why we require IP address, what is the need of the IP address that we require, and why it has been discovered. Okay, so friend, let me tell you that in the very earlier trend, actually we have a very big computers, very huge computer we do have, and it was very tough to share the information among those computers because the hard drive, the hard disk, it was supposed to be very big. So in that particular case, what the people have done, they have came up with the network. What the network does mean? The network does mean is the connection of a two and more computer to which we can communicate. That we call as a network. But the major problem that came into the picture was that how one computer is going to recognize the other computer. Like, we will say, one computer is this, right? A PC1 and PC2. How these both computers will going to recognize each other? How this both a computer recognize to each other that yes, it is a PC1, it is a PC2. For example, if you want to send any of the courier or any of the letter to your house, or you want to make any of the correspondence with any of the office or anything else, so what you would require? Obviously, you would require the destination address. In that particular case, you will act as a sender, and to whom you are going to send particular correspondence would be the receiver. The same particular case had came between the computers, that it is the receiver, it is the sender, but how they are going to recognize it? By some address. That address became as an IP address. IP means internet protocol address, right? It was a logical address. Why we are calling it as a logical address? Because we can't see it, we can't touch it, only we can use it as a concept. If we talk about the physical address, I hope you know that the physical address is referred as a MAC address, what we are having in our devices also, in our laptop also, in our PC also, everywhere. It's a hexadecimal physical address. But IP address is a logical address. Now, this logical address has to be understood by the computer. This is the mandatory thing, that it has to be understood by the computer, and that is why this address is being represented in a binary, like it's a 32-bit address, and it is also divided into IPv4, IPv6. These are the two versions, IPv4, IPv6. IPv4 is of 32-bit, IPv6 is of 128-bit, correct? 32-bit and 128-bit, in which IPv4 is the popular one which we are concerning with, although IPv6 also came into some of the areas, but still it need to be frequent. Now we will discuss about IPv4. Now this IPv4 is of 32 bit, right? How this 32 bit is going to be organized? Like this: A.B.C.D. in which each and every thing is represented as an octet, like 8-bit. It will become the 32-bit. This 8-bit means 2 to the power 8, which is 256. Same here. And that is the reason, friends, that the value of A, B, C and D, it can only varies from 0 to 255. And that is the reason, for example, if I am having the IP address like this, then in that case, this particular number cannot lesser than 0, and it cannot go after 255. Okay, this is the reason behind this, because it is 2 to the power 8, which is 256. Now, This IP address became a logical address to which each of the computer could recognize each other, right? And it is being divided into 0 to 255. But now, these all IP addresses have been divided into 5 classes. Okay? These classes are named as A, B, C, D, and E. Okay? Why we have divided these classes? Because IP address consists of 2 bit, network bit, host bit. Now what is this network bit and the host bit? See friends, network is a collection of a host, or we can say a network is a collection of a clients, right? So one entity we have is a network and one entity we is having a host. So network bit denotes the network ID, host bit denotes the host ID. And a speciality between this is network bit or network ID cannot be changed, but host bit keeps on changing, right? It would be static throughout the network. So IP address contains of a network bit and a host bit, or we can say the 32 bit is being divided into N and H. Now, it has been divided into the 5 classes. These 5 classes represented as 0 to 127, 128 to 191, 192, 22, 23, 224, 2239, and 242, 255. It has been segregated like this, in which this D and E, it is being reserved. It is being reserved for the research purposes. So it's not being used as a daily routine in the organization or by our personal use. So we are concerning with these three. These all three are the ranges as an A, B, C. But now, we as a human being know ki, okay, these are the three classes, but how we are going to make our computer understand that this IP address belongs to A, this IP address belongs to B, this IP address belongs to C. So, for this reason, we are having another concept which we call as mask. What is mask? Now, as I told you, every IP address that consists of network bit and a host bit. Now, what is mask? Mask is the concept which actually differentiates between the network bit and the host bit, in which it makes the computer understand, okay, if this number of network bit is there, it belongs to A. If this number of host bit is there, it belongs to B. Right? Now, for A, the configuration of the mask is like this. Have a look. N dot H dot H dot H. For B is N dot H dot H. And for C is N dot N dot H. Now you can have a look over there that the network bit is over there is 8 and the host bit is 8 8 16 8 24. Similarly, here the network bit is 16, here the host bit is 16. Here the network bit is 24, here the host bit is 8. Now what we can interpret from this? We can interpret from this is how many of subnetwork come under this IP address. How we can calculate it? The formula is 2 to the power n. And how we can calculate that how many number of host could come into this particular class is 2 to the power h minus 2. Now, this concept is very important that why we are doing this minus 2 in case of host. So friends, why we are doing this? The 0 and the 255, these two addresses, this 0 and this 255 addresses have been already been reserved for a network address and a broadcast address. We cannot assign this address to any of the host. That is why we are making it less than 2 by the total number of hosts. This formula is applies everywhere. But now friends, as you know that IP address is being used for a public usage as well, for a private usage as well. So these are the public addresses. Now if we want to go by the private addresses has also been preserved from these addresses, and it will be look like this. Private addresses will be this. For A, 10 dot star dot star, for B 172 dot 16 dot 16, it will be vary as 31, and for C it is 192.168.*.* Friends, these are the private addresses. Private addresses means if you would like to make your own network like LAN in your own organization or in your hostel or in your college, then you would supposed to go by the private address. But like we are having a google.com, facebook.com, youtube.com, any of the internet website, they all have sustained with these public addresses. Why? Because these all are the public addresses, and obviously public addresses mean which could be accessed by the public, which will be open for everybody else. But the private network, this is not the case with the private addresses. Why? Because private addresses would only and only entertain by the people who are only privileged with all those things, right? The permission with all those things, okay? So this is the public addresses, this is the private addresses, okay? Now, generally, the private address cannot communicate with the public address. But nowadays, we are having a concept of NAT. Network address translation, in which we can translate the private addresses to the public addresses, and that is why we can communicate with the internet. Because friends, in your mobile or in your smartphone, the internet you are using, the IP address has been provided by your operator. Like if you are using the mobile number of Airtel, then Airtel would provide you the IP address. That IP address would be the private IP address. But how could you able to access the internet over there? By using this concept NAT. And all the IP addresses has been assigned as a DHCP. Now, we have two commands. Quickly, we are going to have this command. One is ipconfig, other is ping. Why we use ipconfig? ipconfig means IP configuration. If you want to determine or identify the IP address of your system, that what IP address you are accessing, then you would have to follow two steps simply. One, open CMD command window and type in small ipconfig. You will have your address would be there, right? And what is ping? Ping means packet internet gopher. Ping command is used to check that whether the connection is alive or not. Like if you want to check that google.com is being accessible to your system or not, then you will simply do open run and type ping www.google.com, enter. If the reply would start coming, then you can say that you are connected with a google.com. Okay? So these two commands are concerning with the IP. And friends, IP is one of the most important component in the internet. Like nowadays we are, you know, looking for some of the cyber crimes, some of the security, some of the hacking. So IP address would play a very important role in all those kind of security measures. Why? Because your IP address, when it has been registered with the who is registered or who is a domain registered, then your address, your mobile number, your everything will get registered with the IP address. And while you are doing any of the crime along with that IP address, then it would be easily traceable by any of the DSP, right? Any of the DNS. And that is why IP address is a very important component over the internet. Without IP address, we cannot communicate over any of the network. IP address is that much importance. Okay, friends. So this is all about the IP address. Thank you.